Dears, now we are going to discuss an important topic that is called AV block. One of the important questions from all the exams. AV block. In a normal ECG, you are taking normal ECG. This is a rough figure. You have P wave, you have QRS, and we have T wave. As you all know, P wave represents atrial depolarization, QRS ventricular depolarization, and T wave represents ventricular repolarization. Now, normal PQ interval is 200 milliseconds or 0.2 seconds. In an ECG paper, it will be 5 small boxes. Now, how we diagnose AV block? AV block means normally from the SA node. The impulse go to the AV node, then bundle off is right bundle, left bundle, Purkinje fibers. If there is any problem in SA node or AV node, there will be a conduction delay. That can lead to AV block. So normally, we will see PQ prolongation in AV block. This will get prolonged more than 200 or more than 0.2 or more than 5 small boxes. That is defined as AV block. So it is divided into 3 degrees. AV block type 1. Type 1 just simply means PQ prolongation, constant PQ prolongation. No other problem, PQ will be more than 0.2 seconds. Like PQ is prolonged, next to PQ is prolonged. There is no progressive prolongation, just constant PQ prolongation. Now, type 2. Type 2 AV block, again divided into two types. It can be Mobitz 1 or it can be Mobitz 2. This is very important. We have to know the exact difference between type 2 AV block among the subdivision Mobitz 1 and Mobitz 2. Mobitz 1 is also called Wengi back. Actually, what is happening here? The happening here is there is prolonged PQ. Some book write PQ or PR, same thing. PQ, that is in progressive manner. It means in first ECG, if its PQ is 300, other will be 400, other will be 500. There will be progressive prolongation of PQ. So like if the ECG, if I am drawing like this, this is the PQ in first ECG, then second ECG PQ will be prolonged and third ECG will be more prolonged, so it goes like this. And sometime QRS drops, it means long ECG, then QRS drops, like long PQ, long PQ, long PQ, and QRS drops. That happens in Mobitz 1, Wengi back. Now, in Mobitz 2, what happens is the PQ will be constant. Constant PQ. Constant PQ means like PQ is prolonged here. No progressive prolongation. Constant PQ prolongation. Prolonged, constant PQ, prolonged. There is no increase. It is 300, next also 300, next also 300, 300. But the problem here is there will be missing of QRS. QRS will be missing. Like in one ECG, QRS will be there. But in next one, QRS will be missing. But the PQ interval will be constant, 300. More than normal, always more than normal. But here it will be this 300. But this is 400, then 500, sometime QRS drops. Here, in first, PQ will be more. There is no problem in QRS. See, type 1 block is sometimes normal, physiological, no need of treatment. No treatment needed here. Just see the cause of it, maybe tension, stress or something. Just see. Mobitz 1 is also not that much important, but you have to choose here temporary pacemaker. Or you can give atropine. Temporary pacemaker or atropine are common for type 2. Type 2, Mobitz type 2 is more important than here. Sometimes you require more permanent pacemaker as well as with atropine. Treatment will be around same here. This Mobitz type 2, it can lead to progress to type 3 block. Type 3 is most important, that is called complete AV block. It can lead to type 3, that is also called complete AV block. Remember, what happens here is in complete AV block, normally atria and ventricle have dependence. Normally first atria contract, then only you will contract, ventricle will contract. Here atria and ventricle contracts independently. There is no connection. ECG become completely crazy, majnoon, pagal, right? Sometimes you can see straight line, sometimes you can see QRS, sometimes this is called the third degree, the main, the dangerous one. Here patient will have symptoms like dyspnea, tiredness. The question they used to give this, sweating, this whole thing you can see. Remember what is happening here, constant PP, PP interval and constant QQ interval. The problem, main problem here is, here P wave will be buried. P wave will be buried in QRS. Like, sometime you won't be able to see the P wave. Normally P must start here, right? This P wave won't be present. Sometime P wave will be buried in QRS. No P wave. P wave will be absent, it will be buried. You cannot see, it is buried in QRS. P wave buried in QRS. And the ECG will be abnormal, sometimes straight line, sometimes you see. The PP and QQ interval will be same. You will be see QRS missing sometime, P wave will be absent and P wave is buried. This is called complete. Now, in some usability question and all, they will give you, some people went for camping. There is a tick that can cause this one, that is called Borrelia burgdorferi. So third degree AV block can arise because of a mite or tick bite, that is called Borrelia, borreliosis. Like they will give you the question, someone went for camping and all. So I think I have given you everything that is very needed for all the AV block. Now, this can be remembered with the help of a mnemonic that is very famous. Here P wave can be wife, QRS can be husband, and the counselor, pacemaker can be the counselor. It means, can be remembered in a good manner. The first degree AV block, two couples are here, married. See, normally, first who will come? Wife will come home, P wave. Then who will come? Husband will come home. Now, first P wave will come, but in first week after marriage, husband start coming back late. Normally, husband come home 8 p.m. But he is coming every day 9 p.m. There is some problem, right? Wife is coming home after her work 5 o'clock, but husband normally come 8, now he is coming 9. It means the family is having degree 1 AV block. Now, after 2 weeks, what happens? Type 2 happens. It means in Mobitz 1, husband start coming 10 o'clock one day, other come, that's QRS coming, like prolongation, 11 p.m. 11:30 p.m. It is progressing every day. And some days, husband is missing. He is not coming home. Only wife is there. P wave is okay, but QRS is prolonged. He come 9:30, 10, 10:30, 11. Some days he is not coming. That is called Mobitz 1. Now, the wife is in danger. Don't trust husband, right? Wife is thinking something doubtful. He called her friend. That the friend is called temporary pacemaker. She will come and counsel the husband, why you are coming late? And they used to give some atropine also, some dose, don't come late. So husband agreed. That agreeal is called type Mobitz 2. In Mobitz 2, what happened? Now husband is coming late, but same time, 9 p.m. itself. But husband is sometime, one day husband come, other day husband is missing. He is coming at 9, if he is coming, but mainly he is missing. That is called Mobitz 2. Mobitz 2, it means husband is coming constantly at 9, late, but mainly they are missing. QRS is missing. So it means it is more severe than what type 1. Here it was temporary. Now she will, the wife will, is stressed now, she will call her friend to stay there. So here Mobitz type 2, we have to use sometime permanent pacemaker. Danger than what? Mobitz type 1. Third degree means, so this old problem occurred. Third degree means, now wife also give up. Husband is not coming home. And normally husband and wife are dependent. Now wife will come her own manner, husband will come her own manner. They don't talk each other. Everything gone wrong. There is no husband, no wife. They are independent, completely Majnun, Pagal, crazy. That is called type 3. This is important. That stage go to the divorce stage. Here also we need a permanent person in the home to make the conflict solved. That is called, here we need permanent pacemaker. That is called third degree AV block. Remember here some symptoms like dyspnea, tiredness, fatigue is the most complete AV block, more dangerous. And remember, Borrelia can also lead to what? Third degree AV block. So AV block is very important. You have to remember for all the exam. Thank you.